Severe thunderstorms and tornadoes ripped through the southeast, leaving death and destruction. The system isn't through yet. We'll tell you who's going to be threatened now. Good morning and welcome to the Weather Center. I'm Will Annan. Once again, in a wide stretch across the southeastern United States, you're waking up to a lot of destruction this morning. We've got the very latest right now from the Forecast Center, and standing by with the latest information is Cheryl Lemke. Cheryl?
Thanks, Will, and good morning. Indeed, a very grim situation across the southeast as we have been witnessing some very dangerous and deadly thunderstorms and tornadoes roaring across the southeast. And in fact, at this point, we have at least 18 confirmed dead across northern sections of Alabama. And I think that in the next few hours, as we start to get into the daylight hours, undoubtedly there'll be more damage and probably more fatalities, too, to assess because of all the damage that has been done across the southeast. Let's take a look at currently where we have some tornado watches. Still a large part of the southeast under the gun. Parts of North Carolina, a large part of South Carolina, central and southern Georgia, and northern Florida remain under a tornado watch, meaning conditions are favorable for tornadoes to form in and around those watch areas. This morning, still some very powerful thunderstorms roaring across the southeast, packing lots of lightning. As we zoom in a little bit closer, we have two distinct line of thunderstorms that are still roaring through central and southeastern Georgia. At least for Atlanta, you're in the clear right now. But notice these very powerful thunderstorms near the Macon area. They have spawned possibly tornadoes, and currently we have tornado warnings now for Bleckley and northern Pulaski counties in central Georgia. A possible tornado was sighted 8 miles northwest of Hawkinsville, moving to the east-northeast at some 60 miles per hour. There's another very dangerous line of thunderstorms coming down across southeastern Georgia. And here we also have tornado warnings for Long, Tatnall, and Appling counties. There's been a possible tornado near Route 121 moving quickly to the northeast at some 50 miles per hour. And now these thunderstorms are just crossing the border, entering parts of South Carolina. And here, too, we also have some tornado warnings this morning for Beaufort County in South Carolina. Until 7 o'clock this morning, you're under a warning. So you can see these clusters of very nasty thunderstorms roaring across North and South Carolina. And besides the severe weather, we've also had reports of very heavy rain and a very heavy downpour in progress currently for Raleigh-Durham, making for a slow morning commute. And we have rough weather, too, that extends southward into Florida. Right now, Suwanee County in northern Florida under a severe thunderstorm warning for about the next 35 to 40 minutes or so. We're seeing an especially strong cell right there just to the east of Perry. That is Suwanee County under a severe thunderstorm warning. Well, rough weather has been no stranger to the Atlanta area, and overnight we saw a tornado that touched down in Cobb County in the northern part of Atlanta. Now, this was shot about an hour after the tornado swept through Cobb County, which is northwest of Atlanta, just a couple miles from the Weather Channel. The twister left streets littered with debris and tree limbs. Power lines were ripped from the poles, sending flashes into the air to match the electrical display from the storm itself. Many business owners will find their stores heavily damaged this morning, a situation that probably will be matched, too, by many homeowners across the southeast. So it's going to have been very rough across the southeast. There have been scores of reports of downed trees and power lines, large hail, very gusty winds, and tornadoes across the southeast. And speaking of tornadoes, there are some specific safety tips to keep in mind in case you're in the path of severe thunderstorms. Seek shelter in the lowest level of your home, preferably in a basement. Also, stay away from windows. Try to crawl underneath a heavy piece of furniture, maybe a heavy table, something to protect yourself in case there's falling debris. Again, keep away from windows and keep it tuned to a radio or a TV station where you can keep in and monitor the latest weather situation. What we have going on this morning, still a very strong jet stream that's screaming across the southeast. Upper level winds clocked at over 120 miles an hour. So a lot of energy with these thunderstorms and a lot of moisture too being pulled up across the southeast with dew points 50, 60s and 70s. And that will certainly help to fuel and energize these thunderstorms. Our primary trouble zone today, along and ahead of the cold front. So right there in that warm sector, that's where some of the most violent thunderstorms will likely be occurring. And as the storm system continues to move out, it's going to be producing some locally heavy rains too across the northeastern states. And with more details about how this storm could be impacting the Northeast, let's go back to the studios and Will Annan. Will?
Thanks a lot, Cheryl. Once again, we'll be tracking that rainfall northward today, and some of that rainfall could be locally heavy as it reaches Pennsylvania and farther points northward as well. I'll show you what's going on right now with our current weather map, and you can see all the rainfall beginning to spread its way northward right now. Still looking at some violent weather, by the way, and we'd like to pass this along very, very quickly for you folks that live in northern Dodge County, Lawrence County in the state of Georgia. Also, in western Liberty County and also Long County in southeastern Georgia, under tornado warnings now for about the next 30 minutes. Keep that in mind. I'll show you what's going on as we look at the northeastern part of the nation. Looks like the prime area today for looking at more heavy weather is going to be the Carolinas up towards Norfolk, Virginia. Just plain rain. It could be a chilly rain at that throughout much of Pennsylvania for the upcoming day as well. And it will be reaching New York City a little bit later on. The big storm system itself, located right now over eastern Kentucky, and the warm front trying to bow its way northward, is going to be an overrunning type situation that develops across Pennsylvania and much of central and southern parts of New Jersey.